performance in his crime. On Newsmakers 2014, we talk rather to the lover of Motown music, father, a legal expert, and a future farmer. And we will leave you with this story. My name is Willis Oburu. Remember, successful people look like you. Let's do this again tomorrow.
So I enjoy listening to the music on my iPod, old time music, but also I love listening to old Motown music. Fantastic.
Welcome to the world of the country's top legal advisor, Attorney General Professor Githu Muigai.
It's a fantastic place to relax.
I drive my own car. I drive myself. Except that.
Attorney General Githu Muigai is in holiday mood. Appointed to the crucial post on 27th August 2011, the Nairobi and Columbia University alumni has navigated through the murky waters of law and at times politics.
Obviously, when the captain of the team changes, certain aspects of how the team plays the game may change.
Perhaps what strikes you most about him when you hear him speak is his eloquence and grasp of matters law.
I'm self-taught. But I must be honest that I went to the University of Nairobi Law School when it was, I hope it is today, a fantastic center of learning. I was taught by absolutely brilliant teachers. I went many other places later. I met other teachers. But Okoth Obiando, for example, was without a doubt a complete wizard of the law. I was taught by William Mutunga, very committed, very knowledgeable.
And he has the same depth of understanding of the Swahili language, even though he doesn't seem to think so.
Kiswahili changu sio kizuri sana kwa sababu nimesomea tu ndani cha kujifundisha tu. Kizungu pia nimesomea humuhumu. Kuna wale ambao lugha, pambo lao la lugha la nishinda zaidi, kama Profesa Lumumba, rafiki yangu sana. Ye pambo lake la lugha la Kizungu, la Kiswahili, la Kijaluo. Usiniulize najuaje Kijaluo, najua lugha nyingi. Ni nzuri zaidi. Lakini nimefundisha tu kwa kuwa na hamu ya kujua na nasikiliza wale wanaozungumza sana. Na kwa siasa kuna watu wengi Kenya wanajua kuzungumza sana. Sasa kuwataja kwa sababu watu wa siasa kuwataja. Basi wengine watasema kwa nini hakumtaja mimi.
It is even more evident as he speaks of his family quite fondly.
Mimi na kijana wangu na vijana wangu, msichana mmoja. Kijana mmoja amekuwa wakili 2 weeks ago. So as a TR msichana anasoma atamaliza juu. Na yeye pia anataka kuwa wakili lakini si mimi. Kijana wangu mdogo yule lapo na pension fund yangu ako tu anajikokota kwa shule. Anaenda tu nataka tuende polepole ndani nitakuwa. Hapana, yeye mwenyewe anataka kuwa mtengeneza sinema. Kwa hivyo mimi nitakuwa naenda nini kule Hollywood free kuona nini nikiwa mzee. Mzee zaidi, niko mzee, nikiwa mzee zaidi.
The Attorney General uses the language in various arguments in the most captivating ways. A case in point was the battle of salvos that pit him against his predecessor, Busia Senator Amos Wako.
My predecessor, you will recall, Amos Wako, was taken to court by the Law Society on a criminal charge. The man you see in front of you is the mortician. The patient died on the operating table a long time. If you think the patient should have lived, ask the surgeon. Oh, Amos is my very good friend. We practiced law together for a number of years. Of course, he was senior. He's a person who I talk to very
he's not working, the AG likes to take a little break. One would pin him as a bookworm. Well, he does read books.
Oh, right now I'm reading a very interesting book called The Scorpions. It's about the four most influential Supreme Court justices who served during the time of Roosevelt and just before the Second World War. And it's an amazing story about, you know, how politicians and lawyers and judges and congressmen, you know, come together to move a country forward and sometimes to pull it sideways, but finally forward. It's fascinating.
He also has a fine sense and taste of music.
I love listening to old Motown music. Fantastic.
For 3.5 years, Professor Muigai has served the Kenyan people, and it has not been a journey that has been devoid of its ups and downs.
The proudest moment for me was having the foresight to approach the Supreme Court to tell us whether the one-third rule was to be gradually implemented or not. Because with the benefit now of hindsight, had we missed that Supreme Court intervention, we would have gone into a most chaotic constitutional crisis. Now, the most challenging for me was arose out of the decision by the government, not the decision by the AG, the decision by the government to pay the two outstanding judgments, the one rendered in Switzerland and the one rendered in the UK, as we were trying to issue the Eurobond. The political hullabaloo that followed was to me excruciatingly painful and shocking.
Attorney General has often been accused of misguiding the President on issues such as the hot-button topic of the re-emergence of county commissioners and that of the Security Laws Amendment Act.
Now, the Attorney General can only advise to the best of his knowledge and ability. So, a third party, a critic, a newspaper columnist, or a blogger, or somebody giving a lecture at a university, or a workshop, or a seminar, might be able to say, if the government did this, it was not properly advised. And since it is the work of the AG to advise, the AG is an incompetent person. There's nothing you can do about that. That is the nature of open society and open government. But I can tell you this. In my own experience, and I've now been in that office going to 3.5 years, I thank God for the challenge and the opportunity to serve. We have come a long way in, because government is a huge bureaucracy. I don't think you have any idea how huge it is.
The AG was also at The Hague, where he was sent to represent Kenya.
We are only asking this court to confine itself to law. And we are warning, sorry, that's a strong word, we are cautioning that should this court allow itself to be seduced down the road of reading more powers for itself, arrogate more powers for itself, two things will follow as night follows day. The number of state parties willing to join this court, we would strongly discourage as a state party that the court should go down this road of adventure.
We have a situation where, yes, the president is demanded, but the picture painted was like the Attorney General is quote unquote lawyer who represented the letter vis-a-vis being the defendant.
Oh, well, the president was represented by a very, very competent team of lawyers, both international and local. I think they did their work as one lawyer to another, in my own judgment, very well. I never received instructions to defend the presidency. My instructions, as I understand the law, is to defend the interest of the Republic of Kenya, and that's what I did. It was alleged. many times by the prosecutor, that the government of the Republic of Kenya, which, by the way, I must remind you, that we started the engagement with the ICC before His Excellency the President and his deputy were elected into office. So there was no question whatsoever of changing our engagement, what we had already been doing to suit the new circumstance. We continued our engagement the same way that I had done under the previous administration. And I never pretended to be speaking for anybody else except the Republic of Kenya.
He says the government will also focus on the Ruto case.
The Deputy President has a very, very good defense team. I think they are conducting their defense in a most professional way. In the meantime, I continue to interact with the court. Even on Christmas Eve, I was busy filing with the court huge documents relating to the same case, because that is our interaction, and we will continue to do that until the case is concluded.
I also ask him about this promise he made while being vetted.
Recovery action, injunctive relief, and other reliefs from the court that can recover the money of the Kenyan people.
I can say without fear of contradiction that I have lived to the promise that I have made. I am probably the only person since that problem, since the Anglo-Leasing case began, the only Attorney General or Minister of Government who's left here, gone to Europe, engaged my colleagues on this case. Yes.
The Attorney General believes 2015 will be a year when Kenya will make great strides and that the law in the country will continue to be implemented, hopefully without a hitch. Willis Raburu for Newsweek.